My name is Nicholas Botchwe, popularly known as Afrobeast. I'm from Ejimakwa Bisiade in the Central Region. I'm 22 years of age, going to 23. Dance started for me when I was very little, like at the age of 8 years old when I was in primary 2. But I started dancing professionally 6 years ago. Growing up as a kid, I didn't have the passion for dance. I was just dancing for fun, but I wanted to become an engineer because I had love for math and science. But along the line, I realized dance is my purpose. That's what I wanted to do. But back in the days, I used to dance for fun. The passion for dance wasn't really there like that. So I wanted to become an engineer. So I furthered my education to the university. And by my second year, I realized that the passion for the engineering wasn't really there anymore. What I really wanted to do was dance, like my purpose. Like dance was actually my purpose. But so I had to drop out of school and then focus mainly on that. It was either I go to class and fail and gain nothing, or actually stop school and dance and actually fulfill my dream and actually make life work for me. Dropping out of school wasn't easy for me at all. I actually felt like I made the biggest mistake out of my life, but then the passion for dance didn't stop me because I had problems with my family, friends, and then all the people around me. It wasn't really easy at all, but then I thought to myself that I would never let anyone define me because I am what I define myself to be. So I didn't stop what I was doing, though the struggle was really, really hard. But I didn't stop. I kept pushing, trying to open locked doors with the help of my manager, Quables, and then my dance partner, Lloyd. What keeps me going in this career is looking back at where I come from, what I used to be, and then the direction I was actually going. And where I am now and what I have, what I've achieved so far, it keeps me going. That's my inspiration. Yeah, I feel like I've contributed to this dance industry because though I came to meet a lot of people in the industry already by then, if I'm to say I've actually, and then all the trendy things on social media right now, I feel like 50% of it are my contribution. So yeah. Okay, how I dance into it? Crazy, passionate, and a beast. Yeah. Well, in the beginning, I only had the support of my dad, but it was very difficult for my mom. But then along the line, she actually understood where I was going and actually started supporting me. And she still supports me. Like I have my whole family supporting me right now. The future, I see it to be very bright. And then we hope, we pray and hope it happens. But me and my partner want to put dance, African dance, okay, Ghanaian culture dance on the map and be remembered for it, and also own a big studio in Africa, big Afrobeast dance studio in Africa. I remember some time ago, me and my partner Dancegodlloyd, we went for a show, and then because we were struggling at that moment, so a lot of people were looking down on us, so they didn't really pay us. They were like, oh, I'll pay you guys some other time. So, and we didn't have anything at all to go home. Like, they didn't even care. Like, they seriously didn't even care how we're gonna get home. It was really late. So me and my partner, we walked to a bus station. We begged a lot of people to help us get home, but then they saw it to be one of those people begging over the side that do it for, like, as a job. So we had no option than to sleep in the bus station. Yeah, had to sleep in the bus station till the next day so we could figure out how to get home. What I have to say to the upcoming dancers and people who are going through what we used to go through is never let yourself be defined by others. You are what you define yourself to be. And then if you fall down now and then you stay down, you'll never go up. People actually enjoying life now were once like us. So I believe everybody can make it. If I'm to describe myself in 3 words, I'll say I'm generous, hardworking, and a go-getter.
My name is Lloyd Kujokunedu. I am 26 years old. I live in Ashaiman, and I was born in Ashaiman. I come from Kibi in the eastern part of Ghana.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Dancegodlloyd!
Dance has really changed my perception about life. When I started, it wasn't easy. Like, I didn't even know I needed a management team. You know, like, I didn't know I have to meet up with brands and all of that, you know. So I feel like you need to take life serious and make sure you're meeting the right people, and it makes life very easy for you. My most emotional moment, this story actually made me cry. Like, it's the reason why, I feel like it's the reason why I never want to give up. Like, I remember one day in my room, I was fast asleep, like, around 2 a.m., my mom just entered my room and she switched on the lights. She called me and she told me that she's so disappointed in me, and she didn't know that I could grow up. I could grow up to be this way, you know. She was so mad. She cried, like, she really cried. Like, I didn't know what I was doing with my life. I was so confused whether to dance or play football. And I was looking so, like, disturbed, like, destroyed. My hair was bushy, you know. I didn't have such a light skin now, like, you know. So yeah, I really cried that day. Like, I couldn't sleep again, like. And the next day, I said to myself that I'm gonna make her proud, and look at me now. Now she doesn't even think, I don't think she remembers that. In the next 5 years, I want to be on one of the biggest stages, like the World of Dance, the BET, you know, like the Super Bowl, you know, doing amazing things in the name of Africa. And my team wants to own one of the biggest dance studios in Africa. We really want to put Africa on the world map. So we would want to travel around the world and teach them the culture, because Africa is the future. DWP! If I'm to describe my dance in 3 ways, it's gonna be being skillful, being passionate, being happy, spreading positive vibes. One advice for the up-and-coming dancers or up-and-coming creatives: it's not easy out here, so you need to pray. Prayer is the key, and work hard. Talent alone won't help you. Be hardworking and open up to anything positive. Peace out.
My name is Eleskobla, popularly known as Quables. And I'm sitting here because of this. At the age of 17, there's so many things I wanted to become. So many dreams, so many aspirations. And I mean, the main thing was to be able to be a positive force in the lives of other people, to be able to change people's lives. That was the long-term goal. And I mean, I didn't see how it was going to come to life. I didn't know how it was going to start. I didn't know what it was going to be. And I started doing a little bit of modeling, I started doing a little bit of acting. It was a combination of so many things. I found myself doing so many things. And doing those things, I kind of gained some kind of recognition online. I don't know, if you go back to 2015, 2016, I kind of gained some kind of recognition online and even in person. Because I did a couple of billboards for big brands, MTN, Tigo. Big brands, I've been an influencer for, like, an ambassador for KitKat. So many big brands. Then, I mean, it got to a point, I realized that, okay, I have gained this amount of recognition. My dream has always been to be able to change people's life, or to be able to be a positive person in their life. So it couldn't be about me anymore. It couldn't be about what I do and about the fame and the popularity. It couldn't be about me anymore. It was now becoming more of what I can do for other people. I can't remember, there was a time that I was in church and then the pastor said, "Is anybody in this church who is in Brunei?" So I walked to the front. And I felt like that was I don't cry. That was the only time that I cried, because I felt like at that point everything started coming to mind. Like the times where I thought like, what am I going to do in my life? The times where I thought like, would I be able to make it in life? But I had achieved quite something. The achievement for me is being able to, I mean, every day I see it as an achievement, because being able to go to work and come back, I see it as an achievement, because people wake up and go and they don't come back. So I cried because I felt like I achieved quite a number of things. And I was going back to my seat and he said Quables. And I'm like, huh? How is my pastor calling me Quables? You know, he's not supposed to know me as Quables. I didn't even think he would know my name. Like, Quables. So I felt like, and he was giving a prophecy. So I felt like it was really me he was talking about. And when he called me, they played this song that's my favorite song. That's the song that could actually make me cry. It's called Captain of the Devil. He said that he saw me coming out of the door. And the door was too short. I was too tall. I was too tall for the door that I couldn't come out of the door. And then the person that was closest to me was at my waist level. I mean, my understanding of that prophecy is that I'll go tall. You understand? I'll go tall no matter where I find myself. I'll go tall beyond my expectations or beyond what people think I can achieve. So all of it made a lot of sense, because that was how I thought about life. How I can use what I have or my thoughts to be able to change people's lives. Oh, and behold, there was a time that Dancegodlloyd came to my house. I mean, he kept on calling me so many times. And I wonder why Dancegodlloyd is calling me, because way back in high school, I used to see him as Dancegodlloyd. Everybody knew Dancegodlloyd. He was more like a celebrity in high school. So I was wondering why he's reaching out to me. So he'd come and visit. He could even leave his house, lift him and come all the way to my house. I mean, it's like it's an hour or like 2 hour journey. And he leaves and comes to my house at 11 p.m. He's come to tell me about how things are not going well and how, I mean, he wants to make it. He told me about how he stopped dancing and then he went to play football, and the football was also not working and he came back to dance. So I was like, I'm not a manager. I didn't go to school to study management or anything. I was like, okay, I'll manage you. That's all I said. I didn't know how I was going to do it. I didn't know what I would do or what I would say to people. I was like, I'll manage you. So you'll be surprised. I mean, when I'm going to work, Lord will call me and talk for an hour or two every single day. That's how it was. So it was more like a very personal relationship where we both able to succeed and make this dance thing work. And I mean, it's been a gradual process, and from zero, because I remember when we met, he was about 1,000 to 2,000 followers. Now he's almost at he's over 200,000 followers. I see, I go on his page and I see so many people writing, "I want to be like you. I want to learn from you." They've even changed their name to Dancegodlloyd and all of that. And I'm like, I mean, little do we know that we'll come this far and be able to inspire people. People will want to be like him. You understand? And so, I mean, Lloyd didn't come to me alone. When I started managing him, he decided to bring along his friend. He told me that he has another friend that he wanted to start dancing with, Afrobeast. So I was like, okay, I'm going to manage both of you. I mean, there were three. And I started managing the three of them, but I mean, I think one person didn't believe in the dream, so he decided to quit. I don't know where he is now. So it was just the two of them who decided to keep the dream alive. It's not been easy, because the times where, I mean, we're born for shows and they don't pay us, the times where we have no money. Like, it's not like I don't work. But with everything that we had, we used to put it in this thing that we're doing. There were times where like nobody's calling us, nobody's booking us. Even like there are times where Lloyd would even be sending celebrities DMs and all of that, and they don't reply. And I used to tell him that, you know what, I mean, the time is going to come. The tables are going to turn. You're not going to be moving to these people like you are doing now, and they're not responding. And the tables have turned. You find people making music, and everybody wants Dancegodlloyd to dance to it. But back in the day, when he DM'd them, they don't reply. You see, that's, and I mean, I feel this should inspire a lot of people because, you know, they see the celebrities and all these big people and they want to be like them, but, you know, they don't know how they're going to get there. All I want to tell you is that keep working hard because these same people that you see as celebrities, they're going to get their time. You're going to be on the same level with them. You're going to be on the same level or even bigger than them. Look at Abraham Mata. Like, so many people started acting before him. He just featured in one movie and he's bigger than a lot of them. So, I mean, you need to work hard. Work hard. Don't think that, I mean, maybe, yeah, don't think that you've not reached anywhere. Take every day as progress. Take every day as success, because every single day, every single sweat, that every single thing that you do is a step closer to your long-term goal. So I told Lloyd, I sat down Lloyd and Afrobeast some time now. I mean, we cannot dance forever. You guys cannot dance forever. So, I mean, we need to come up with something that could live long. I mean, could also inspire lots of other dancers, because people keep on saying they want to be like them. So we decided to start a dance school. So we started DWP Academy. So the long-term goal of DWP Academy is to be an institution, a dance institution. But at the moment, we don't have the facility. So what we do is we pay for a studio, we rent out a studio, and then we teach these young dancers how to dance. The reason why we're doing this is because it wasn't easy for us. The journey has not been easy for us, and we don't want people to go to that same family. Roy said there are times where he will sleep at a bus station. That's not like that you see online. You think that it's all flashy and everything is here. I mean, he's been through a lot. And so we don't want people to go through that same struggle. We want to help people monetize their talent. All these young dancers, we want to bring them together. All the dancers in the streets, all everybody who is passionate about dance, we want to bring them close together and help them make a profit out of this. I mean, right now we have over 50 people in the academy. Shout out to all the dancers in the DWP Academy: Danita, Miracle, Leah, Khalifa, Demzi, Timeless, everybody. Everybody, shout out to all the dancers in DWP Academy. I mean, right now we're a big family and we're looking to enroll more people. I think we're the biggest academy in Ghana or maybe Africa right now. Because we have over 50 people. We are looking to sign up more people. The Q17 dream still lives on. Still lives on. So anybody that's passionate about dance or that wants to be part of this big family, you're welcome. You're welcome to join this big family. What I want to say to the youth, not even just dance, everybody out there, is that keep working hard. If I didn't have all the dreams, if I didn't believe that they would come to life, or if I didn't believe that they would be possible, I don't think I'll be here. So keep dreaming, keep working hard.
1, 2, 3, go!
Go!
I don't know if you had to do so. Somebody handed me my hand inside. Charlie, 3,000.
Gang. Bugang.
FFM.
You don't understand.
Hello, guys. You happy?
if he's tired for his baby, he's trying to what he will do to them. My name is Logan. And my name is DH Dance for you. Bye bye.